Hi everyone, it's Cassie Kozyrkov here with a quick 2-minute intro to generative AI art. I'm going to show you how to make the image that's up on your screen near my photograph. First, you're going to need Midjourney, which can be a little bit annoying to install. It takes about 10 minutes with Discord, but once you've got it, using it is as simple as typing /im. You can type the whole word imagine, or you can just choose it from that dropdown, and then you write your prompt. So here I've got a neon, cyan, sea glass, chestnut on a concrete chessboard, violet and pink lighting, magenta palm fronds. And then I watch it generate. And here we go. Ta-da, we've got four versions ready. I like the fourth one the most, so I click on that U4 to enlarge it. And here is that image generated for me. Now, normally it would take several rounds to get the one you want, but I'm just gonna go with this one. I'm gonna drop it into Photoshop. And I'm going to ignore all this other stuff. I'm going to use the simple regular select in Photoshop, the square select, and then I'm going to write in the prompt bar exactly what I want it to be. All of these chess pieces are pawns. Okay, they aren't quite, so I have to go back and I'm going to fiddle with them individually and ask for each one to be a pawn. And over here, I want this to be one sphere only. And then I'm going to go through and I'm going to make these tiny little modifications here and there. And see, it doesn't always work, but if you fiddle with it enough, you're going to get something fun eventually. And see, it gives me multiple options, so I can actually click through those arrows until I pick one that's good enough to work with. And continue from there. Now I want to clean the base up, and so I want to say take the base of that knight and smooth it into the lighting scheme. And now I just need one more pawn, and that's my image, and I just save it the regular way. Not hard to do at all. In fact, this isn't an AI tutorial, it's a UI tutorial. And I'm showing you this not only to show you how easy this is — people make such a fuss over generative AI, it is really easy to be a user of it — but also that this isn't about AI. From Adobe's perspective, from Midjourney's perspective, it definitely is about AI. But from your perspective, it's just a much better version of Photoshop. And of course, the illustrator who knows the better version of Photoshop is likely to be more competitive on the market than the illustrator who's using the old version. But that's nothing new. Software is supposed to make you more efficient at your job, and it's great when there's a big leap in productivity with a new version. Now, if you're actually interested in AI from the builder's perspective, then that's the kind of stuff that I have on my channel. So if you're interested in a 6.5-hour introduction to machine learning and AI that's fun for beginners and experts alike, do check that out on my channel. And of course, if you like what I did here, then do like it with a like, share, subscribe. Catch you next time.